Good morning to all of you friends, students. This is the second lecture of robotic process automation. Before this, again for 2 to 3 minutes, I want to discuss the previous lecture. What we have done in previous lecture, we have discussed all the basics of RPA. What are the benefits of RPA? What are the process that can be automated or the process that cannot be automated, various types of ports. That's all we have already covered in previous lecture. Okay, now from this lecture we will start, or you can say that for today's our agenda of our lecture is the control structure and functions. This is the same as that of you have already studied in your C language, C++, Java, whatever the language or the programming language that you have studied till now. These are the control structures or the functions that you have studied till now is the same as that of the today's that we are going to discuss. Okay. First of all, I am going to tell you what are the control structures and then we'll discuss the functions. Okay. You all are aware about these control structures. Okay, these are the following, you can say that types of decision, or you can say that control structure that we can implement in a workflow. Listen, we have already discussed that for every process we will make a workflow. With the help of that, the process or the instructions, you can say that in a particular program, the instructions are to be executed in a manner in which it is written. In the same way, we will create a workflow for any of the process, and in that workflow, the statements that is to be encountered will be executed sequentially. You can say that. Okay. Now we will discuss the control structures. Okay, you all are familiar with these control structures. First one is if statement. In this RPA, whether it is any kind of thing, we will call it as an activity. Okay, so keep in mind for future that if we are talking about the activity, means the thing is same. For example, you use the if statement. If statement is same, but we are here call it as the activity. Okay, this is all about the introduction. Okay, I am not telling you, even I have not shown what is the framework of the RPA, or the you can say that UiPath Studio. This is to be continued from the unit 2. But before that, in first unit, we will discuss theoretically each and everything that is to be used in our subsequent units. So first of all, we will discuss over here the control structures, or you can say that decision types of decision making statements. In that scenario, our first activity is if activity, second is switch. You all are familiar about the if and switch. If else, you have already studied the if statement, if else statement, nested if. Okay, switch activities, flow decisions and flow switches. Next, for each activities, it is the same as that you have already applied the for loop. Okay, what is the syntax of the for loop? We are not going to discuss it over here, but while we are using this particular activity in our bot, or you can say that in our workflow, then you will recall that the same syntax is same as that of the for loop. Okay, next is while and do while activities. Up to some extent, or you can directly say that these all are the loops. Okay, you are control statements. Here the point is control structure. You can say that control statement or the control statements structure and the statement both are the same thing over here. Okay, in this particular lecture we will discuss if activities. Okay, switch activities, flow decisions, flow switches, for each activities, while and do while activities. Already told you that In C, C++ or Java, you have studied if statement, if else statement, nested if else statement, switch statement, flow control, flow switches. You didn't study this flow decision and flow switches, but you all are familiar about the flow chart. Okay, we'll discuss this thing later. Next is for loop. Here you will use for each activity, while loop and while activity, do while loop, and this is do while activity. Okay, next is, I think we are it's not required to go into the depth of this, what is if activity, what is else activity, if else activity, what is switch activity, right? Even then, I am telling you about this. These are the following types of decision or control structures we can implement in a workflow. First one is our if activity. If activity is used to check whether a particular condition is satisfied or not, it will give the results in a Boolean form, either yes or no, whether the condition is to be satisfied or not satisfied. Okay, if activity is used to check for a particular condition or expression, if that expression or the condition is satisfied, then block will be executed, otherwise else block will be executed. You all are very much familiar with this particular term. Okay, now we will discuss the use of this particular activity in our UiPath workflow. In UiPath workflow, you can search if activity from activity panel. You are not familiar, sir, what is panel, what is activity? We will show, I will show you each and everything, but just listen to me. While you are using, with the help of UiPath Studio, while you are making any kind of workflow, first of all, there will be a platform where you will find if. Simply you write I if in the search box, and simply that if activity you will write, that you will search that particular if activity from the activity panel and add it to by drag and drop. Okay, basically the if activity splits a sequence vertically and then for a short linear branches. Okay, if means if else something like that. It depends upon the situation, what kind of situation we are facing. On the basis of that, we will implement this if activity. Okay, this is what I am telling to you. This is a kind of flowchart. Okay, in this flowchart, this is input dialog, this is again input dialog. I am not telling you what is this, what is that and all that. I just simply telling you how our syntax is to be executed, how our syntax is to be written. Simply, first of all, we will discuss how the syntax will be written. This is a kind of flowchart, okay? Because from second unit onwards, we will work on the UiPath Studio. That is a platform, or you can say that the framework where we will design our workflows, we will design our boards. Okay, but before that, what kind of activities, what kind of you can say that concepts or the terminologies that we will face over there. So first of all, we will familiar all these terms and terminologies. Such types of images I am using in throughout my PPTs, so that you can familiar up to some extent that how this particular if activity can be used. This is what the flowchart is. Okay, for the time being, I am telling you there are three things. First one is our sequence, second one is our flowchart, and third one is our automata, finite automata. These are the three types of things with the help of which we can create our workflows. So this is the flowchart. In this particular image, the flowchart is to be taken for making the workflow. In this flowchart, this is start, then input dialog, next input dialog, and then if statement. Then this is one. What is if? When you double click over here, this image will be opened. If this is the condition, if is already written. Okay, this is the condition. You all are familiar that if means you are going to check a particular expression, you are going to check a particular condition, whether the condition or the expression is true or not. You simply write now, if A is greater than B and B is greater than C, something like that. In the same way, you simply drag and drop the if activity by entering the if if into the search panel and drag and drop that particular activity into the panel. Okay, such types of thing is to be written like this. If while this particular activity is visible over here, after drag and drop, you will double click over here. This is double click to view. When you will double click, this will be open. Now you will put the condition. If condition, what is condition? X plus y is less than 6, then else. If the condition is true, then part will be executed, or else part will be executed. You all are familiar with this thing, that if the condition is true, then will be executed, otherwise else will be executed. This is all about the if activity, right? Next is switch activity. Switch means whenever you have a more than one choices, whenever you are having a situation where there are multiple options to choose, in that case you will use the switch activity. This is same as that of you have already used in C or C++. Switch activity can be used to make a choice. When we have various options available and wants to execute one option, we frequently use the switch activity, right? You can search for switch activity in the same way that you have find the if activity if. You have written if in search bar and drag and drop that if into the your framework. In the same way, you will search for switch activity from the activity panel and drag and drop to the workflow design. The switch activity by default uses an integer argument. This you keep in mind. Switch activity by default uses an integer argument. We can also change it to boolean, because object, string, etc. From the property panel under type argument list, as shown in the following snapshot. I am going to see you a particular snapshot. In that snapshot, you will check how you can change the argument, or you can change the type of your argument. I have already told you in switch activity by default uses an integer argument, but you can change it into the from integer to boolean, or the object, or the string, or etc. from the property panel. But where is that property panel? We will discuss it, right? This is a sequence. I have already told you that there are three workflows. First one is sequence, second one is flowchart, and third one is finite automata, or you can say that finite state machine. Okay, and this is our sequence. In the same way that we have searched in if, we have searched for switch into the search bar. Same way, first of all, while we are decided that we are using for a particular workflow sequence, for a particular workflow we will use flowchart, for a particular workflow we can use finite state machine. In that case, after decision of that particular thing, we will search that particular keywords into the search bar and drag and drop, the same way as if is to be done and switch is to be done. In the same way, this is the sequence, this is your input dialog. Everything that is the if you need input dialog, you simply search this particular activity into the search button or the search bar. If you need if, you will search if into the search bar. You want switch, you will see, you will search for this particular switch into the search bar, and from there you will drag and drop into your main area, or you can say that the framework where you are building your workflow, right? This is the expression. This is input dialog, enter any number. For example, the number is next. This is what the switch is. Expression is k mode 2, default case 1, right line k dot 2 string plus is used for same as that of the we have already used in C and C++ for concatenation, is an odd number, right? This is the sequence again. Enter any number, the number is switch, expression is k mode 2, case again 1. This is k dot 2 string is an odd number. I think something is wrong over here, because when I have created this activity, one is for odd number and another is for even. Okay, we will discuss, we will see over this. So in this particular scenario, I just want to tell you, you will use the switch operation when you are having the multiple operations. Which operation you want to choose, or which operation you want to execute, you will simply put that number into the cases statement in front of the case. Like this is expression is k mod 2, you simply write case 1. For case 1, it is k dot 2 string. Okay, plus is an odd number, like that of the is an even number. Right? For example, this is case 1. No, it's okay. We will discuss it later. Okay, this is all about the switchability. Then flow decision. Flow decision, or simply you can say that a decision, is an activity that execute one of the two branches, by default named either true or false. This kind of execution will depends upon whether the specified condition is met or not. We can change the name of the branches in the property panel. Okay. Flow decision is basically equivalent to the if activity and can only be used in a flowchart. Again, listen very carefully. Flow decision is basically equivalent to the if activity. Flow means, I have already told you in the previous point, that by default either the true or the false, one of the branches will be executed. You can say that flow decision means simple decision. In the same way, flow decision is basically equivalent to the activity, if activity, and can only be used in a flowchart. We can search flow decision from activity panel and use it in a flowchart by drag and drop. Point and the concept is same, that you find the if, you find the switch, in the same way you find the either sequence or flowchart or finite state machine. You simply drag and drop that particular activity into the working area, right? Next is flow switches. Switches, again the same thing, multiple options, multiple branches. If you, we are talking about the flow decision, the decision is either true or false. But in flow switch, there are multiple options. Flow switch is an activity that splits the control flow into, if we are not taking, we are not talking over there that only the two branches or the three branches are there. We are taking about the three or more branches. Okay. Among them, only one will be executed, and the execution will depends upon whether the specified condition is met or not. Okay, we can connect more than 12 cases. Listen, in flow decisions, you are using only the two decisions, either true or false. But here, you can connect more than 12 cases by starting more connections from the same switch node, and connected activities are automatically numbered. Whether the first one would be the default case. If you are not going to, if you are not providing any case, default will be the first case. Or you can change the name of the cases from the, again, the property panel, right? This is all about the flow decision and flow switches. Next is for each activity. For each activity, I have already told you, this is same as that of the for loop. Now, for each means item in names. You can see this particular thing that I am telling you in this particular snapshot. For each activity is used to iterate over the array. It will pick up one name from the array each time until it reaches the end. Until or unless the end will be reached, each time it will pick up one name and show that particular name. Okay, this is all about the for each. In the for loop, you are simply say that for I is equal to 0, I is less than 10 and I plus plus. What does it mean? You simply initialize the value of I is equal to 0. And then you put up the condition ki I is less than 10 and I plus plus, or whatsoever the condition you want to write. In that case, what will we do from 0 to 10, or the condition, whatsoever the condition is, whether it is greater than 10 or less than 10 or less than equal to, greater than or greater than equal to, whatsoever the condition you have written over there, you simply test until or unless your condition will be executed each time one particular thing that you have written corresponding to your code will be executed. Okay, this is all about the for each activity. Next is while activity. Same as that of the while loop. Is used in the automation to execute a statement or process based on a certain condition. While I is greater than equal to 10, the initialization condition, and you can say that the increment or decrement. This will be same for for loop, while loop, and do while loop. All three things will be same, but how we can write it matters. In while activity is used in automation to execute a statement or process based on a certain condition. If found true, the loop is executed, that is, the process is executed repeatedly. The project only exists from the loop when the condition does not hold true. Until or unless condition is true, it will rotate into the loops. As the condition is false, it will exit from the loop. Okay, this activity is useful while iterating through an array of elements. This is while activity. Okay, this is the snapshot of your while activity. This following snapshot gives an insights about the while activity. This is the sequence that you are taking for designing the workflow. In sequence, you are using the while activity. In this while activity, what is this? This will be the condition. Condition is x is less than 50. In body, again, you are using the sequence. You have initialized x equal to x plus 5. And what you want to write? X dot toString. This is all about the while activity. Next is do while activity is same as that of the while. But the difference is same that you have already learned in the previous semesters. Do while activity is used in automation when it is required to execute a statement based on the fulfillment of a certain condition. How it differ from the while activity? Same. It execute a statement that checks whether the condition is fulfilled. If the condition is not fulfilled, it exits the loop. Okay. In do while activity, condition will be checked at last. Like in this particular snapshot, you have already assigned y equal to y plus 2. You have already written y in write line activity. You are using the write line activity to write this y. Whatsoever the value of this y equal to y plus 2 is over here, it simply write y. Then the condition will be checked. Whether the condition is true or not, doesn't matter. Your code one time has already been executed. This is all about the do while loop. Next is assign activity. Assign activity is used to designate a value to the variable. You all are known that what is assignment? You simply put something into a particular variable. That is what the assignment. This is the same as that of the activity that we have already learned in previous semesters. Assign activity can be used for different purposes, such as incrementing the value of a variable in a loop, or using the results of a sum, difference, multiplication, division of a variable, and assigning it to the another variable. This is the assign activity. Next is delay activity. Delay, you will give the time, at how much time you want to provide for the delay. As the name suggests, this particular activity is used to delay, or you can say that slow down an automation by pausing it for a particular or a specific amount of time or a period of time. Workflow continue after the specific period of time. Okay, it is in HHMM-SS format. This activity play a significant role when we need a waiting period during automation. If you required some duration for wait in the automation, you can include this delay activity over there. Okay, for that particular delay time will be stopped. Your workflow will be stopped at that particular moment of time, and after that it will start automatically. A waiting period required for a particular application to open. Right. Next is delay activity. In this snapshot, you simply say that to better understand how delay activity works, you simply, this is the flowchart, write line, hey, what is your name? Then delay. Okay. This is the delay. Delay means when you will click over here in property panel, you can set the timing, how much time you are going to provide the delay. After that particular delay, the right line is my name is, like for example, Andrew NG. Whatsoever the name is, whatsoever the reply will back, that will be written over here after a particular pause or the delay that you have already introduced in this particular activity or the workflow. Next is break activity. Break activity is used to break, or you can say that to stop the loop of a particular point and then continue to the next activity according to the requirement. It cannot be used for, or you can say that by any another activity apart from the for each activity. It is useful when we want to break the loop to continue to the next activity in the for each activity. In this particular scenario, you can see over here. This is your for each loop, for each item in X. This is body. Then write line item dot toString. Before this is the for and this is the write line. in that, between that, we have already applied the break activity. Okay, this is break, and references are same that we have already discussed in previous lecture. You can use these textbooks as well as the reference book, or you can use this academy.uipath.com, because your complete syllabus, you can say that the complete information about the UiPath, UiPath studios and everything, that will be available in this particular URL. You can go through these URLs, and have any doubt, you can ask me anything. Okay, thank you so much. This is all about your second lecture. Okay, again, I am going to brief for you that in this particular lecture, we have discussed all the control structures, or you can say that control statements, like if statements, if else statements, nested if statements, switch statements, and for each statement, and for loop, you can say that while loop, do while loop, okay, assign activity, delay activity, break activity, continue activity, these all are the activities. But in previous semesters or in previous studies, we have already studied control statements, and we known it as a loop, but here we will use it at an activity. Okay, this is all about this particular lecture. You simply read these things, okay, and we'll discuss if you have any doubt. Okay, thank you so much.